excited about the material thing. Come on. I wish I could get a church in here. That knows that Jesus is the reason for the season. Can I get one witness in here?
Yeah.
Nehemiah 8 and 6, and Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people answered, amen. Amen. Lifting up their hands, they bowed their heads and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. When we receive a word from the Lord, our answer should be amen. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Let them say amen. If you believe the word, let the whole church say amen. God has spoken.
Yes.
So let the church say amen. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. God has spoken. So let the church
Thank you.
Yeah. I was reminded of your nails, so I held on. Amen. So lo and behold, I'm going to share this to the glory of God. Lo and behold, in October, it was for our appreciation service, and we were here appreciating what God has done and celebrating what God was doing in our life. Amen. And so much was going on in the spirit realm. We went home, and when we left home, our television was working just fine. But when we went home, the television was no longer working. Oh, I'm going, y'all going to get it just in a little while. So when we got home, was no longer working. Amen. And so we looked at this big thing in our living room and we said, well, see, God's got a way of moving out the old and yes. wanted to introduce you to the new. Yes. Oh, yes. yes. I want to testify and tell you that sometimes we're holding on to something that's taking a place in your life that should no longer be there. I want to tell you that God's got this newness and this freshness that he wants to give to us, but some of us is trying to hold on to stuff that God says is over.
Yeah.
But the Bible says, take heed unless you fall.
Yeah. That's
true.
Right.
Oh, see,
that's
you,
all right.
See,
uh-huh.
Fall from the pitch was short. In church, very deeply,
yeah.
Stay with them.
Uh-huh.
Seeking to rise from the
floor. That's right. That's right. That's right.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Yeah. have some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. And some lonely nights.
Bills are due. Don't know where the money coming from, but thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. want a heart that's holy.
I choose to worship. Savior, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes. Let's give God some praise. Amen.
Broken in the wilderness for his glory. There's a lot of hurting women in the world. And we're not just talking about worldly women. I'm saying we're talking about in the church. In the body of Christ. Many of us got hurt. And we have on the right shoes, the right stockings, the right hairstyle, the eyelashes, the makeup, all of that stuff. And we're still hurting on the inside. My Bible tells me that I am a daughter of God. And if you're a daughter of God, that means he's our father. That means we're siblings. That means I'm supposed to look out for you. When I grew up, if one of my brothers or my sister got into a fight, my mother would immediately look at the rest of us and say, where were you? Where were you at? Did you help them fight? And if we didn't help them fight, then we got in trouble. We got a whoop. It is time out for us. We need to stop killing our wounded.
Come on.
Stop kicking our wounded.
That's right.
See, our church on Sunday, we praise the Lord, sis, how you doing? Oh, you look nice, sis, how you doing? Praise the Lord. What about when she weeped at your husband?
That's right.
Can you still say praise the Lord?
That's right.
What about when she yelled at your kids a little bit rougher than you think she should?
That's right.
Can you still, sis, how you doing?
Yes.
What about when she talk about you?
Yes.
You're on the phone and your best friend call you and tell you what she gonna say on the phone to you? Is it still sister?
Right.
Or do we have a problem? Or do they become a rock of offense unto us?
Right.
We have to stop hurting our wounded people.
Right.
See, people act out like that, they're wounded. There is always a back story that you don't know. People don't wake up one morning and say, I'm going to talk about folks. People don't wake up one morning and say, I'm going to commit adultery, I'm going to take my husband. There's something that happened way back then that produced this stuff up here. And until we get the way God wants us to be as women and start seeing about our sisters and stop being offended every time they do something to us, we're never going to be what God wants us to be. These women are hurt.
That's right.
And we can't afford to let another wounded soldier die.
That's right.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Oh, God,
we bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we give you glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
want y'all to sing this with me like it was Sunday morning. If you need something that you know you can't do for yourself, if you need God to work something out that you've been trying to work out and you just can't figure it out in your own strength, in your weakness, His strength is made perfect. Some of y'all are real cute, you just been leaning on God. But I dare you to get personal and stretch out on Him. Just learn how to stretch out in His back and lay on Him. If you need God to do it, I want you to point to yourself and make it personal and say, I need.
Jesus.
Please revive us.
can leave any church when he can go. Please revive us. In our marriages, we need you, Jesus. Please revive us. In our finances, we need you. In our minds, we need you to provide. Thank you.
I Disappoint me. In the life of someone in this room, for many of you have felt as though you were on the verge of something, but you didn't know what it was. You have sensed in your spirit that God was getting ready to do something awesome in your life. You have encountered warfare and conflict and been confused why you have gone through as much as you have gone through. But the enemy knows that you are on the verge of a great blessing and a tremendous release. This is no time to give up. This is no time to draw back. This is no time to faint. For now is your salvation nearer than when you first believed. You are on the verge of a spiritual revolution, and the devil knows it. The pot shots he's been taking at you are to discourage you, because if you take another step, you are going to step into your destiny, and the power of God is going to break loose in your life. Look at somebody and say, keep moving. There is a word from God to the woman. The word from God to the woman is that you are going to produce your own deliverance. Your deliverance is going to come out of your own womb, out of your own spirit, out of your own barrenness, out of your own vacuum. He says you are going to birth a deliverer. And in order to birth it, you must be prepared to push. If then a woman does not develop within the complexity of her own spirit a tenacity and a resolve to push, she will never receive the things of God. You can be feminine, but you dare not be too passive. Because if you become too passive, the enemy will walk in and out of your life at will and take whatever he wants to take. There is a war going on. Look at your sister and say, girl, you're in a war. The prophecy says there will be enmity or conflict between the woman and the serpent. There is a tenacious, ongoing conflict between those two entities. Now understand something about injustice. You don't have to fight when there has been injustice. If you continue to walk with God, I don't care what the devil tries to do to you. If he kills the flesh of you, the blood of you will cry up out of the ground. I'm so glad to know that the battle is not mine, but that it belongs to God. And if I hold my peace and let the Lord fight my battles, victory without me operating in my flesh, victory without me becoming hysterical, victory without me having a nervous breakdown, shall be mine. Touch somebody and say, it shall be mine. Now the enemy knows that you want it. And anytime the enemy knows that you want something, that's where the warfare is going to be. He will try to wear you down with weariness and discouragement and disappointment and forlornness. He wants to beat you down so low that you give up on the promise. But I came to tell you that there's a prophecy hanging on the top of your head. And in spite of everything you went through and everything life took you through and every mistake you made, God has still opened his mouth to bless you. And no devil in hell can stop the word from coming to pass in your life. Look at somebody and tell them, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. He's after the seed of the woman. Not just the woman, he's after her zeron. He's after the male child that she shall produce. Now notice then in Exodus, when the Pharaoh heard that God was going to send a deliverer, he did not send out a decree against the woman. He sent out a decree against her men. He said to the midwives, when the Hebrew women go into labor, if they birth a girl child, let them live. But if she produces a zero, choke it to death and destroy it. Oh, but devil, you wait. You wait, and a man named Moses was born, and God send a deliverer. Touch somebody and tell them the devil wins. See, that devil thought he had you. But every now and then, God will open up a window and bless you in spite of your circumstance and in spite of your situation. Touch somebody and say, I'm still going to get it. Even Jesus, when the time came that he was to be born, a decree was released against the veiled child, because the devil knew that it was going to be the Zera, the seed of the woman. And God caused the woman to bring forth her child in the wilderness, in an odd place, born in a manger. I know some of you want to produce the blessing of God in a nice, neat, comfortable place, but in order to produce what God promised you, you may have to get out of your comfort zone. Before this thing is over, you may have to kick off your shoes. You may have to hang your cute dress in the closet and go into spiritual warfare to produce what God has promised you. Before this thing is over, you may have to put up your trophies for the best dress, find this woman in Tampa, and get down on the floor and go into labor and tell the devil he is a liar. Touch three women and tell them, I'm going to war. You have to let them know that you're going to war. Because if you don't prepare them, they will think that you've lost your mind. Just because you're not walking around with your nose stuck up in the air trying to be cute, they'll think that you lost your mind. But some of us didn't come here for that. We came here to receive something from the Lord. We didn't come here for a pageant. We came here to put on our tennis shoes and march into the enemy's path. Somebody tell them, I didn't come for that. I don't want to hear no gossip. I don't want to hear no foolishness. I don't want to get in no war with you. I don't have time to have a cat fight. I didn't come here to play games with you. The devil is trying to destroy my house. He's after my mind and my marriage. And I came here to do warfare in the name of Jesus. Somebody shook off. Everything that you have ever gone through has been preparing you, getting you ready for what God is going to do in your life. I mean the good and the bad. The ugly things, the painful things have been the catalyst that God is going to use to usher you to the upper echelon of spirituality. If you have not endured anything, you cannot produce anything. Some of you have been wondering all of your life, why did you go through what you went through? And you've been running around with a big question mark on your head. But if you had not gone through what you went through, you would have never learned how to worship God like you did. If you hadn't gone through what you went through, you'd still be walking around with a limp wrist trying to be cute and impress people. But after you've been through hell and high water, you don't care what anybody thinks about you, because you want a blessing and you don't care how much it costs. How many radical women do we have in this house? Somebody and tell him, I'm not leaving till he bless me. Whatever it takes, I'm willing to do it. If I have to lay flat out in the floor, I'm willing to do it. If I have to sleep with my head on my Bible, I'm willing to do it. If I have to sweat out my makeup, I'm willing to do it. If I have to pray while other women play, I'm willing to do it, because I need something from the Lord. Leave here without getting everything that God has for me.
those seeds you have sown, you're gonna come into your own. Seeds, water to your seeds. Yes, I do.
Seeds, seeds
everywhere. Those seeds you have sown, you're gonna come into your own. Seeds,
walk into real seeds.
I will believe, will in the time, God's gonna bless the same. Those who stay, those who pray, He'll keep the promise that He made. For I hear the Spirit say that it's your time. The way goes, walk into your seat. Yeah, you're gonna come into your own.
Walk into real seas.
I know that you invested a lot. The return has been so low. You throw up your hands, say, I give up. I can't take this anymore.
Always on your side.
The song just simply says, if he doesn't do anything else, he's already done enough. Bishop Brown wrote this song for me. Hallelujah.